The Xtreme Walleye Angler is presented by Go Fish in Ontario, It's Catching. Welcome to Marten River Lodge, a premier fishing and hunting resort located in Northeastern Ontario's Temagami region, catering to outdoor sports enthusiasts, family cottage vacations, situated amongst old growth forests and a multitude of pristine lakes with excellent fisheries and wildlife abound.
All right, another fantastic road trip to Northeastern Ontario, and this time to a place that I've been a few times and it's fantastic. The owners at Marten River Lodge, Ray and Donna Sapiano. Man, this place is phenomenal. They got fantastic fishing right on the river, but it's the remote lakes they have and the lakes that are close by that we're gonna go look for those big walleyes or even maybe some eaters, because I wanna have a traditional shore lunch, because I'm coming up here, I wanna have a good time, and I wanna make fantastic memories while fishing with some good people.
So we're sitting about 15?
Yep.
There's drop off here, huh?
Yeah, about halfway across, there's a rock shoal that sticks out.
Gotcha. Seems like those fish are concentrated more up this way, aren't they?
Yeah, I marked a lot more in the 20 foot than the 15 foot.
Yeah.
It's mid-September towards late September. Everything's changing. The fish are moving around a lot. So we're going to fish those mid-lake shoals and humps and different things out there. And you just can't go up to a spot and start jigging and stuff traditionally like I like to do. But these guides, they know how to find these walleyes.
What are we, about 20 feet or so?
20.4.
There's the bottom. Now I'm all hyped up. Understand? I'm all hyped up.
There's one.
Wally?
I think it's a bass.
Is this gonna be the bass show? Let me know.
Small walleye.
Small walleye. Just too small for shore lunch, huh?
Yep. We like them a little bit bigger than that.
Yeah. That 14, 15. Walleye time. Catch and release.
So we're again going to power drift with the blade and bead and hopefully catch some eaters to have a great shore lunch.
Here we go. Wally diver, is it? First walleye. Oh, smallmouth. Wow. I came all the way to Marten River for smallmouth. It's like deja vu. Deja vu years ago. I'm back, everyone, at Marten River Lodge. And we're fishing for walleye this time. And guess what happens? Oh, yes. We're hooking smallmouth. That's all right. You know what that is, Sam? That just shows me that fish want to bite today, dude.
I like that.
Yeah, man.
It's always a good sign.
Yes. Well, Mr. Smallmouth, I know I will love you, but I'm not here for you this time. We're back at Marten River Lodge for walleye with our guy, Sam Rose, drifting the go-getters on one of the lakes of Marten River chain. And we're gonna have some fun, man. You know, late September, and it's about catching some walleyes, having a short lunch, and just enjoying the fantastic camaraderie and the lodge life up here in Northern Ontario. I'll show you the whole setup. We'll get back down, catch some more fish. Hopefully, they're walleye.
Now, I'll be the first to admit, I love fishing for big fish, especially big walleyes. But all across our province, we have the regulations about 18 and overs and stuff. And even up here in Marten River, we're allowed to keep 4 fish each, but we don't want anything over 18 inches. So any bigger fish we caught, we're gonna release anyway. But I was up here to enjoy myself and have a really good time at the lodge and experience the whole ambiance, good people, good camaraderie, meet other people, talk about how the fishing is and stuff. So as long as we catch some eaters, I'll be happy.
Sam got him?
Yep.
What you got, Sam?
Oh, I think
walleye
it's a
diver.
Walleye.
In your net?
He feels better than the last one.
That looks like eating size, doesn't it?
That's an eater size.
That's
one.
An eater size. Yay, we're officially on board. Officially on board. I can all even help you. I will open the live well. Attaboy, Sam. Fish number one swimming in the live well. These were getting bit. The rain's staying away. And we're fishing. We're gonna keep catching. Some of your favorite stuff up this way?
This is one of my favorite shoals right here.
Gotcha.
We spend most of our season catching them in 10 to 12 feet.
Wow.
It's just around the start of September they move into this deeper
water.
Yeah,
for sure. Cool. You get all kinds of sizes out here, Sam?
Yeah. Your majority of your better fish are out here.
Right. Close to the main lake, right?
Yeah.
There we go. There's fish. Oh, what do we we got Wally. Might be Walter. Actually, doesn't feel bad. Come on, Walter. Is it Walter? Yes, it's an eating size too. Look at that.
Oh, excellent.
Hey?
That's the one we want.
There it is. Marten River System Walleye. KK. But good old Sam's on the spot. The go-getter, boy. We're going and getting them. On the edge of a shoal, right there. Look at that. The eating size. Now, Sam says it's 16.9. You're allowed to keep four. 16.9 or under. Or 1 over 23. We're not going to keep any big ones, but maybe we'll catch a big one. But it's different in different areas. Some areas are like 18 and below. You're allowed four, 1 over 18. But here, 16.9 is the deal. That's the perfect eater right here for Marten River. We're going to put them in the box, and we're going to have some shore lunch today, man. All right, Wally, ready? Go on in there. Join your buddy. Shoal hugging with the go-getters. So let's go get another one.
As you can see, Mother Nature threw us a curveball and decided not to be just flat and calm on a perfect September day. Wind, cool temperatures, a little bit of rain, drizzle, but we all know, you fish for walleyes, they don't care. They bite all year long, springtime, summertime, fall, through the ice, you name it. That's the beauty of walleyes, but it's about us getting out there, braving the elements and catching those fish. And these walleyes definitely didn't care about that. All they wanted to see was that little worm or minnow on the back of that blade, and they ate it.
Got him?
There's
got him. Let me know if you need the net, boy. How's it feel?
He's a better size one, yeah.
Always an eater too, eh?
Yep.
Oh, in the net. We're gonna have lunch, dudes. Yes. We're gonna have lunch. Traditional Ontario walleye lunch. We're getting there, one fish at a time. Perfect eating size. There's another one right there. Uh-oh, it's a small one. Karl got a small one, but he's just playing possum. Look at that. Think of that, hey? Little smallmouth, yeah, yeah, oh yeah. The bass came back out at me again. Well, I should be eating those. Get out there.
Sam was great just power trolling, but he was back trolling as well too, because you want to control the speed that you're going.
The sun's back out.
The trigger.
Maybe you need to get back on those deep ones again, eh?
Oh,
there's a good one. How's that feel?
That's a bass.
Oh, is it?
Yep.
Chunky bass, there he is. Chunky little smallmouth. When you said, I thought, chunk. I thought it was walleye time.
Yeah. Head like a walleye.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Catch and release, folks.
This time of year, the walleyes are scattered. So you have to remember that little split shot you have above the line, you got to alternate. Sometimes two split shots, but not too heavy, or you get snagged up on the bottom. Bottom contact is paramount to getting bit. So it's a fine line with using too much weight and not enough weight. But you just got to make sure that that little split shot's bouncing bottom. And again, use a sensitive St. Croix so you feel when it's bouncing the bottom.
That's why I put that one sinker on, so I can bounce over these things a bit easier, you know?
Absolutely.
A little bit of line out. The stuff on bottom right here.
Yeah.
That's a good one right there. That's a good fish. Oh yeah. That's a nice fish. That's a good fish, buddy. Oh yeah.
What do you got there?
I don't know if it's a pike or a nice walleye. Let's see right down here, baby. Let's see. Oh, nice walleye.
Oh,
hey?
Beautiful.
Nice walleye. Well, he's probably over the range, isn't he?
He's probably around 17, I would say, or he's right on the line.
And you're now at 16.9 is the key, right?
Yep.
Okay. I'll take a quick picture with him. How's that sound?
Well, we can measure him on the side of the board
there. Okay, sure. What do you think, Mr. Walleye? Hey, hold on. Chunky, chunky fish, boy. Look at that. Hey, Marten River right there. Okay, what does the board say?
Right on the side there. That black, the first black mark is 16.9.
This is?
Yep.
From here?
From right from there, and fork the tail right down.
Wow, he's under. right?
Slide him right there.
Yeah. Look at that. He's an eater.
He's an eater.
He's an eater. He's about 16 inches.
He's an eater. Ooh, nice chunky yellow walleye. I love you boys, man. Man, talk about patience and stuff. Just got to be patient. Going along, Sam's got us on that edge, back trolling so he can control it. And with a wind like this, you know there's no way you can go forward because you're totally out of control. But you stay back, drift on the bottom with the little go-getters, and we're going and getting them. Let's put them in the box. This is a setup right here. Look at this. That's Sam's homemade deal. I got my cross lock or little swivel right there to my fluorocarbon. Split shot, then a swivel to his homemade leader with the go-getter and the unique little blade. Look at that little thing. It's like L-shaped, whatever it is, but it probably gives off a little bit more vibration. He's got his little beads, nice setback hook, bait holder, and it's catching some walleyes, some pike, some perch, and some bass. Let's keep going.
But those bites, you can't miss it. It's just a distinct tick, or it's just a mushy feeling like a wet leaf is on your line. Reel up slack line, set hook, catch those walleyes.
There we go. Feel like a Walter?
No. Big perch.
Oh, big perch. Still could eat the size.
Big
eh?
Perch.
You need some perch too? Look pretty good, eh?
They have worms in them.
Do they?
Yep.
Okay.
Just the perch.
Okay.
Doesn't really affect
so
any of the other fish.
Beautiful and release.
Yep.
Oh, they are nice looking perch, boy.
Where there's perch, there's usually walleye.
Nice.
Now I've got to give all the credit in the world to the guides, especially the lodge owners. They put so much effort in to make sure that all their customers, and hey, I'm a customer here now, and has a great time. And the camaraderie again, like I said, we had the American plan, so we had meals with the owners and their friends, and just talked about fishing, talked about good things and stuff. And it's about that ambiance of being at a lodge. Like, it really is more than just the fishing. Like, don't get me wrong, I love the fishing. That's what I do. But I mean, people come up here to enjoy all kinds of things like kayaking, boating, you know, walks in the wilderness and stuff, as well as the fishing. And you're going to make memories like I do for the rest of my life when I'm visiting lodges like this all across Northern Ontario.
There's one. Out of what? Any size?
No, I don't think he's very big. No, another
big perch.
Perch,
eh? Wow. Big jumbo.
Yep.
Hi, my name is Ray Sapiano. We're here in Marten River. My wife Donna and I own Marten River Lodge. We've been up here for 7 years now. It's a beautiful, beautiful part of the province here in Ontario. And we have guests that visit us from literally all over the globe. We have 9 cabins, beautiful historic lodge. The camp is 94 years old this year. And we specialize in all-inclusive remote lake fishing experiences for our guests. We offer fine dining. We have beautiful cabins that are fully equipped. Our guides are expert, very knowledgeable on the water, and very experienced at getting people on fish. We have 11 different remote back lakes that we fish, some accessed by drive-to, some by UTV, some by Argo, and we also have 4 fly-in lakes. Once again, my wife Donna and I invite you to visit us at Marten River Lodge. We think you'll really enjoy it. Many of our guests, we're very fortunate, our return guests every year. And we think that that once you come and pay us a visit, that you'll become a return guest again too. Look forward to having you. Thank you.
Just have a look around. How many of the boats do you see? It just goes to show you that here at Marten River Lodge, they've got the connections and they just have the know-how to go to different lakes within the vicinity of the lodge and find places where there's virtually nobody. It's just you, fish, and the elements and Mother Nature. How can you beat that?
Fish right there, dude. What's Karl got? He's got his little walleye. Oh, he's staying down. Might be, it is. A little walleye. He's just, look how light they bite. Look at that. Look how light they bite. Wow, eh? Oh, you're just too small. We got some decent ones to eat. But he's got a little attitude, huh? You got a little attitude. Oh, look at those little vampire teeth. They kill me, man. Okay. Come on, boy. Oh, see him jump? He thought he was a smallmouth. Let's get back at it. Whew.
Now, as for rod choices, when you're using the blade and bead, right here, the St.Croix 7-foot medium light, and I got it with a little spinning reel with braid. Now, Sam hand-tied these little blade and bead combinations with about 18 inches to 2 feet of fluorocarbon, so I could tie that right to my little ball-bearing swivel. The reason I use a ball-bearing swivel is I don't get line twists and stuff, but with the braid, I have virtually no stretch. So the 7-foot rod picks up any slack line when I feel a bite, reel up, set hook, catch those walleyes.
How deep?
14.
Uh-oh. We're in the walleye zone, boys. Look at that dark cloud cover. It just looks mysterious. Creepy. Creepy walleye.
There's
another. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Oh. Tail dancing smallmouth. Whoa. Look at him go, folks. We got a dancer. Nice jumper. If anything, it was nice scrap.
Yeah.
There's one right there.
You got one, too?
There's Karl got. Oh, another small ball. This is going to turn into pandemonium. Bassmaster champs. Hey, Bassmaster champs. Wrong species on this trip. Wow, easy, boy. Easy, man. Are you ever ornery? Look at yours. That's a chunky. That's a chunky, isn't it?
Yeah. It's a good size one for a deer.
I got the little guy. Go away. Whoa. See that? Just wanted to say I got you. Bye.
Now, depending on the time of year to come to Marten River Lodge, we came in September, so I brought some extra boots and jackets and some tipless gloves and different things, just so, you know, if we had to get out there with the wind stuff, we can brave the elements and be prepared. Different rods, you know, there's different species you want to fish for, bass, pike, walleye. Right up here at Marten River Lodge, they've got it all. You just got to come prepared, and you're going to catch those fish.
There's a fish.
How's he feel?
Not very big.
Not very big?
Nope. Another walleye.
Another little walleye. Almost getting that size. You're almost getting the size. They're not there yet. In the right zone.
Now it's time for shore lunch. You talk about being prepared. They've got different spots on the lakes that they fish that are pristine. There's no one else around, fire pit. They have everything else ready to go. So I could just sit back like a customer, wait till the fire's ready, wait till the grease gets hot, put those walleyes in there, put all the extras like the beans and potatoes and different things, and just have another fantastic memory to put in the bank up here at Marten River Lodge, fishing for walleyes, eating the walleyes, and just enjoying every moment of this fantastic experience. This trip truly was the ultimate outdoor adventure. The sheer beauty and serenity of Northern Ontario is truly addictive. All of our trips to Marten River Lodge have been stress-free, uninterrupted, and seamless, and as a testament to the overall service, TripAdvisor Certificate of Excellence was awarded to Marten River Lodge in 2018. Ray and Donna Sapiano are proud of their lodge and facilities and hope that you will spend more time looking through their website and learning more about what they have to offer for you for your next fishing vacation. This lodge has so many fishing opportunities, from main lake trips to guided back lake excursions, fly-in day trips, and a wide abundance
of species such as northern pike, smallmouth bass, lake trout, and the ever-popular walleye. This lodge is truly an angler's paradise and much, much more. And to conclude, this trip wouldn't have turned out to be so perfect were it not for our guide, Sam Rose, who made sure we were on the best spots with the proven techniques and baits and kept us on the fish the entire day despite whatever conditions Mother Nature decided to throw our way. I personally encourage our viewers to call Marten River Lodge to book your next outdoor adventure in a true Canadian wilderness setting with all the comforts of home.
So overall, Mother Nature did not win. Despite the high winds and the different dropping temperatures and the barometer all over the place, those walleye still bit. Sam Rose put us on them. The lodge owners made sure we had good accommodations and food and camaraderie. So once again, you see why you should consider Marten River Lodge in Ontario for your next fishing vacation. Because man, go fish Ontario, because you know it's catching.
So plan your next outdoor adventure at Marten River Lodge by calling them at 1-800-561-2067 or visit them on the net at martenriverlodge.com. The Xtreme Walleye Angler has been presented by Go Fish in Ontario, It's Catching. St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Catch us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.